Hi Melissa of La Rossa Creazioni. In today's video, I will show how to crochet a bodice for a sundress for a 18 months old baby. But you can easily adapt this pattern to other sizes by following the instructions of the previous video tutorial on how to design a dress. You can adapt this bodice for a custom made one, but you can also turn it into a pretty summer top, perhaps adding a ruffle edge on the lower side. This pattern can also be adapted to any occasion. Just change the type of the fabric, the crochet stitch or the yarn, and so you will have a complete different result, suitable for every age and occasion. The particularity of this pattern is that it's one piece, that is that you will cut the yarn only at the end of the bodice, so it's an easy and quick project. The bodice is composed of a rectangular band that is closed in this way with 3 hood buttons of 1.5 cm in diameter. For the pattern, don't change anything where you choose to put the opening. You can freely choose as the front side of the bodice, the side with the opening, or the other side. It's totally indifferent. You can do as you prefer, and don't change anything. Moreover, I have chosen to make adjustable suspenders made of two laces closed with a bow, but you can do them differently. For this project, I used the Anchor Baby pure cotton, and I used less than one ball of the beige color, and I worked it with a 2 mm crochet hook, and I used also 3 hood buttons of 1.5 cm in diameter for the opening. So these are the materials for this project, and for this bodice I have chose this crochet stitch made of only double crochet and a 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster. But you can freely adapt this pattern with any other crochet stitch. You can find the full pattern with written instructions and charts in my blog. You can find the link where to find everything in the info box of this video. Now let's start the work. From the sample in the previous video tutorial, I found that for a 18 months old baby, I will need of 121 stitches to have a bodice of the right size. So let's start the work and do 121 chains, or the number of chains needed for your size. I worked more chains for safety because it can happen to jump some chain in the count, and so to have some stitches in less at the end of the first row. In this case, the pattern lets me to do more chains to prevent this. I will unthread the chains in excess at the end of the first row. Let's start the first row. First of all, I have to do 3 chains, so chain 3. Note that the 3 initial chains count always as first stitch of the row. Now, in the 5th chain from hook, so in this chain, In the fifth chain from hook, I have to do one double crochet. One double crochet stitch, so in this stitch. Then one double crochet in the next stitch. Now again one double crochet in the next stitch and so on. The first row is a row of only double crochet stitches and continue with one double crochet stitch in all next stitches. I have done 121 stitches and these are the chains that are in excess. Now stretch the work on the table and measure it. Control that it has reached the length necessary for your size. In my case it is about 52 cm length that corresponds to the crochet body's circumference for a 18 months old baby, so I can continue with the work. But before I want to show how to unthread the initial chains that are in excess. You can help you with a pin or a needle to unthread the initial chains. So let's take the beginning of the foundation chain. I have to pull the initial thread, this one. And so pull out the thread in this way. You can do only with the hands. So pull the thread and continue with the second chain. And in this way, unthread all the extra chains step by step, pull the thread and pull out all chains until to reach the last chain where there is the last double crochet. This is the last chain where there is the last double crochet stitch. Pull the thread in this way and now I have unthreaded all the extra chains. So I can continue with the work and with the second row. Turn the work in this way and now let's start the second row. Chain 3, so 1, 2, 3, and then 1 double crochet in next stitch, in this one, 1 double crochet. Now, as you can see in the chart below, now I have to do the first motif of 3 cluster stitches. I have to skip 2 stitches and in the following one, 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster. So skip 2 stitches and in the following one I have to do the motif of cluster stitches. Let's do the first cluster stitch. Okay, in the this stitch, yarn over, insert the hook in this stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. Stretch well the loops on the hook. I have 3 loops on the hook. Now yarn over, insert the hook in the same stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. And stretch well all the loops on the hook. I have in total 5 loops on the hook. Now I can close the cluster stitch. So, yarn over and draw through 4 loops on the hook in this way. And now I have only 2 loops on the hook. So, yarn over and draw through the last 2 loops on the hook. I have done the first cluster stitch. Chain 1 and now I have to do the second cluster stitch. So yarn over and insert the hook in the same stitch. Yarn over and pull up a loop. Stretch well the whole the loops on the work on the hook. Yarn over and insert the hook again in the same stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop and stretch well the work. Now I can close the 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster stitch. So stretch well the work and yarn over and draw through the first 4 loops on the hook, yarn over and draw through the last 2 loops on the hook and chain 1 and again 1 cluster stitch. So yarn over and insert the hook in the same stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over, insert the hook in the same stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, stretch well the work. And now yarn over and draw through the first 4 loops on the hook, yarn over and draw through the last 2 hooks loops on the hook. Now it's the first motif of 3 cluster stitches is completed. Now skip 2 stitches and in the following one double crochet. So skip 2 stitches and in this one double crochet. Now one double crochet in next 8 stitches. I have done the last double crochet for a total of 9 double crochet stitches. And now I have to do the second motif of cluster stitch. As the first one, skip 2 stitches and in the following do the first 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster stitch. So let's do the first cluster stitch as you have done for the previous one. Chain 1 and make the second 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster stitch in the same stitch. Chain 1 and do the third cluster stitch in the same stitch. While you are working the cluster stitches, keep attention to stretch very well, hold the loops on the hook. Now I have finished the second motif of three cluster stitches. Skip next two stitches and in the following one double crochet. Then one double crochet in all next eight stitches. The second row is composed by a sequence of a group of, eight, of nine double crochet stitches followed by a motif of three cluster stitches. This is the sequence that I have to repeat for all the second row. I am at the end of the second row. I have just done the last motif of three cluster stitches. So now skip next two stitches, one, two, and in the following one, in this one, one double crochet. Okay, one double crochet in the last stitch, that is in the third initial chain of row 1. So in this chain, okay, in this chain, one double crochet. Okay, I have finished the second row. Turn the work. Okay, this is the aspect of the second row. Turn the work. And let's start the third row, that is a row of only double crochet stitches, as you can see in the chart above. Now chain 3 and one double crochet in next stitch. Now one double crochet in next stitch that corresponds to the first cluster stitch of the last motif of the second row. So one double crochet in this stitch. Okay, in this way. And then one double crochet in the chain 1 space. This is the chain 1 space between the two cluster stitches. So and then one double crochet in next stitch. One double crochet in next chain 1 space. And one double crochet in next stitch. Now 1 double crochet in next stitch, 1 double crochet again in next stitch, and so on. Continue with 1 double crochet in all the stitches of the previous row. When you arrive on a group of 3 cluster stitches, work 1 double crochet in the first cluster stitch, 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space, 1 double crochet in the second cluster stitch, 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space, and 1 double crochet in the last cluster stitch, and then continue with the work with 1 double crochet in all next stitches. So now continue with 1 double crochet in all the stitches of the previous row.
Sono arrivata alla fine del terzo rigo e completo con questi due punti alti. L'ultimo punto alto lavorato nella terza catenella di base. Ok.
Ok, I have just finished
ecco
the row number 3 and
è
this is
il terzo
how
rigo
the work
di soli
looks
punti
like.
Alti. Ora
now,
a questo punto
turn the work
giro
and
il
let's
lavoro.
Start the row number 4. That is a row with the cluster stitches. In this
giro
case,
il lavoro ed inizio
I will
rigo
start
4.
The row with
il rigo
9
4
double crochet stitches
inizia diversamente dal
the first
dal
group
secondo
of 3
rigo.
Cluster
Qui avevo
stitches.
Iniziato con soltanto 2 punti alti, ora inizio con
so,
9 punti
now,
alti. Quindi
chain
3 catenelle che valgono come primo punto alto
and
e
one
continuo
double
con
crochet
un punto
in all
alto
next 8
in
stitches.
ognuno degli 8 punti seguenti, quindi
I remember
uno,
you
questo è
that
primo,
the three
secondo, due.
initial chains always count as first double crochet stitch. So 1 double crochet in all next 8 stitches. For a total of 9 double crochet stitches.
Ok, 2, 4, 6, 8 e 9. Sono 9 punti alti. Ora posso passare
so
al gruppo
I can
di punti
start
puff.
The first motif of cluster stitches.
Avvolgo il filo sull'uncinetto.
I have to
salto
skip
2
two
punti.
Stitches, so 1,
2 e inserisco
and in the following
nel terzo
one,
punto e qui lavoro
do the first cluster stitch
il punto puff
that is a 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster stitch. Keep attention to stretch
ecco.
All the loops on
due
the hook
movimenti. Tiro bene e chiudo
and close
il punto
the stitch
una
chain
catenella
1 and 1
ed ora
cluster
lavoro
stitch
l'altro
again
punto puff.
In the same stitch.
Tiro bene, avvolgo di nuovo caccio e tiro bene tutti gli occhielli ed ora avvolgo e chiudo il punto.
Ok, chain 1,
una catenella e poi di
and
nuovo
again
l'ultimo punto puff.
1 cluster stitch.
Tiro bene, stendo per bene tutto. E chiudo il punto.
Ok, I have completed the first
ecco il
motif
dei
of
3
cluster stitches.
Ora salto
so now
queste due
skip two
questi
stitches,
due punti di base e nel terzo
and in the
vado a lavorare
one
il
double
punto
crochet
alto. Ed ora lavoro un gruppo
and
di 9 punti
now
alti.
One double crochet in all 8 next stitches. Ok, I have completed a
Ecco qui
group
un altro
of
gruppo di
9
9 punti
double
alti,
crochet
3,
stitches.
6, 3, 9 si trova. Quindi ora, dopo questo gruppo di 9 punti alti, continuo con i
So
punti
I can
puff.
continue with the
Ora
second
avvolgo il filo sull'uncinetto, salto
motif of
2
3
punti,
cluster
inserisco
stitches,
l'uncinetto nel terzo e qui
skip 2
lavoro
stitches
il
and
primo
in the
punto
following
puff.
one do
Avvolgo il
the
filo su di
first
nuovo.
2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster.
Tiro per bene, avvolgo e chiudo il punto.
Chain 1
Ora una catenella
and a
e
2 half
faccio
double crochet chain 1
l'altro
cluster
punto puff.
again in the same stitch.
Ed ecco
Chain
fatto.
1
Ora una catenella e un altro
and
punto puff.
a 2 half double crochet chain 1 cluster
Tirate
again
sempre
in the
per
same
bene.
stitch. And in this
Ed ecco
way
fatto.
I have completed
Ho
the
completato
second group of 3
anche
cluster
questo gruppo
stitches.
di 3 punti puff.
Now I can
Ora
continue,
salto 2
skip
punti,
2 stitches
ma
and in
2
the
e nel
following
terzo
one,
lavoro
one
il
double
punto
crochet,
alto. E da qui continuo
then
con un
one
altro
double
gruppo di 9
crochet
punti alti.
in
Quindi la sequenza
all
di questo
next
rigo
8 stitches.
è di 9
The
punti
second
alti, poi
to repeat in this row
un gruppo di
is
punti di 6 punti
one
puff,
group of 3
poi di
cluster
nuovo 9
stitches
punti
and
alti,
then
gruppo di punti
one group
puff.
of 9 double crochet stitches.
Quindi questa è la sequenza per tutto il rigo.
So now
E continuo ora con
let's
questa
continue
lavorazione
with the row
fino ad
number
arrivare alla fine del
4.
rigo.
Ok, I have just finished the row number 4 and this is how the work looks like. And as you can see, the group of 3 cluster stitches is of the fourth row is shifted to the middle of the space between two groups of 3 cluster stitches of the second row. This because I've started the fourth row with a group of 9 double crochet stitches instead of only 2 double crochet stitches as at the beginning of the second row. And so I have this pattern. Ok, now turn the work and let's start the fifth row, that is a row of only double crochet stitches. So now chain 3, 1, 2, 3. And 1 double crochet in next stitch. 1 double crochet again in all next stitches. And so on, continue with 1 double crochet in all the stitches of the previous row. One double crochet. Now I am on the group of 3 cluster stitches, so 1 double crochet in the cluster stitches, 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space, 1 double crochet in the next cluster stitch, 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space, and then 1 double crochet in the next cluster stitch, and so on, one double crochet in next stitch for all the row. Now I have showed you all the base sequence of this pattern that is composed by this first, fourth row. The fifth row is a row of only double crochet stitches as the first row. Then the sixth row, it will be as the second row, so a row with cluster stitches, but at the beginning only two double crochet stitches. Then I will have a row of only double crochet stitches, followed at the end with a row with the cluster stitches, but started with a group of 9 double crochet stitches. So this is the sequence to repeat until to reach the desired height for your bodies. Now I'm working the fifth row, that is a row of only double crochet stitches. Then I will repeat for the next row, I will repeat the second row with the cluster stitches and only two double crochet stitches at the beginning. Then I will do a row as like the third row, so a row only double crochet stitches, and then I will work a row with cluster stitches, but at the beginning 9 double crochet stitches. So this is the base sequence to repeat until to reach the desired height for your bodies based to your size. In my case, I will stop at the 30th row to obtain a height of about 10 cm, because this is the dimension necessary for my size, that is for a baby, a 18-month old baby. So I will continue with the work until to reach the 13th row, but you have to continue until to reach the desired height. Let's continue with the work. Another important thing, hand work always with a row of only double crochet stitches. In fact, I will stop at the row number 20. That is a row of only double crochet stitches. Okay, I've just finished the row 13. I've reached an height of about 10.5 cm. So I can stop at this row, but you have to continue until to reach the desired height for your size. Now I have to do only the finishing edge all around the work, doing also the suspenders and the button holes. But first of all, the right side of the bodies correspond to the right side of the rows of only double crochet stitches. For example, the last row is a row of only double crochet stitches. This is the right side of the double crochet. So this is the right side of the bodies. Now fold the bodies as it will be at the end, so in this way it will have this aspect. Okay, now the button holes will be sewn on the left side, and on the right side there will be so the button holes, and on the top I will work the suspenders. The suspenders are formed by two laces closed together with a bow. Now, before to start working the finishing edge, I have to divide the work and find the positions of suspenders and button holes. In total I have 121 stitches. But at the end there will be two more stitches because I have to work the finishing edge of only single crochet stitches. So I will work I will do single crochet stitches on this side and then I will do the same on the other side. So I will have one more line of stitches on the right side and one more on the left side. So I will have in total two more lines of stitches. But these two lines of stitches at the end they will be overlapped. So at the end I will have only one stitch only one stitch from the finishing edge. So 121 stitches plus one stitches from the finishing edge is equal to 122 stitches in total. 122 stitches in total that divided by 2 give 61 stitches. So 61 stitches on the on the back side and 61 stitches on the front side. Now one stitch is given by the line of the finishing edge. So I have to count 30 stitches on this side and 30 stitches on the other side. Okay, let's count 30 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 30. Place a stitch marker in this stitch. Okay, do the same on the other side. Let's count 30 stitches. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 30. Place a stitch marker and so I have divided the work and these are the stitches of the front side. 30 stitches, 30 stitches. One line of stitches of the finishing edge and so 61 stitches on the front. Now I have to do the suspender at 5 centimeters away from the side. So 5 centimeters away from the side that correspond to okay from this point 5 centimeters away this stitch correspond to this stitch. Okay, let's count how many stitches are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Eleven stitches. This stitch is the 11th from the red stitch marker. Now report the same thing on the back. Start to count from the stitch before the place mark the stitch marker. So 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And control that it's all okay. This stitch has to be 5 centimeter away from the side, so it has to be 5 centimeter away from the stitch before the red stitch marker, So, measure it and it's okay. It's right. 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters from between the white stitch marker and the stitch before the red one. Okay. I will do the two laces of the suspender in these two positions. Now do the same thing on the other side. So okay. These are the 30 stitches of the front side. Now let's count 11 stitches from the red stitch marker. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. Another. Okay. And on the back. Oops. Okay. Okay, and now start from the stitch following the first stitch following the stitch marker and count 11 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. Now control that it's all right, and so 5 centimeter between the white and the red stitch marker. Okay, 5 centimeter and 5 centimeter between the stitch following the first stitch following the stitch marker and the white stitch marker. So Ok, Mr. It's all right. So now these are the position where I will do the other suspender. I will do the two laces of the suspender of the right side. So I found the positions of all the suspenders. Ok, it's all matches. Ok, now for the button holes. On the right side of the bodies, I have to work 3 button holes. Ok. This stitch maker is not useful anymore. Ok, I have to do 3 button holes. I will show 1 button on the last row. So 1 button holes there will be on the last row. 1 button on the first row, and so 1 button holes on the first row, and 1 button in the middle row. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 rows. So I place a stitch marker on the sixth row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the middle row. In fact, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ok, these are the positions where I will do the button holes. So now I've just found the position where I have to work the button holes and the suspenders. So I can start crocheting the last round of the so I can start with the finishing edge. Now let's start the finishing edge. The finishing edge is around only single crochet stitches. Ok, I am at the end of the last row. It is a row of only double crochet stitches. So now chain 1. I will work in these spaces. These spaces are the row hands. A row hand is the space between the last or the first stitch of the row and the rest of the work. In this case, for example, is the space between the last double crochet stitch and the rest of the work, but in the previous one, the row hand is the space between the 3 initial chains and the rest of the work. So I will work 2 single crochet stitches in all the row in all ends. So now let's do 2 single crochet. 1. Work in this space. That is the space between the last double crochet stitch and the rest of the row. Okay, I've done 2 single crochet stitches. Now in the following row head, 2 single crochet. Okay, continue. 2 single crochet stitches in next row hand. Again, do 2 single crochet stitches in next row hand, and so on. 2 single crochet stitches in whole next row hands until to reach the last row hand. Okay, I'm arrived at the last row end, and this row end make 4 single crochet stitches. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and okay, this way, and 4 single crochet stitches. Okay, now I've just finished to work the edge on the first side of the bodice, and now I have to work on the lower side. On the lower side I will work 1 single crochet stitch in all the 3 loops of the foundation chain. So in all of these 3 loops I will work 1 single crochet stitch. This is the aspect of the edge on the first side, and so I can continue. 1 single crochet in all the 3 loops of the foundation chains in this way. So 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet in the next stitch, 1 so on until to reach the other side. Let's continue with 1 single crochet in all the 3 loops of the foundation chains. Okay, now one single crochet in the second last base chain. And now I have to work in the last in the space of the last base chain. This is a chain for space because one chain from the base chain plus the three initial chains of the first row. So I have to work in this chain for space. Okay, now two single crochet stitches in this space. One single crochet stitch that corresponds to the single crochet stitch that I should have to make in the last base chain, and one single crochet stitch to turn to the other side of the bodice. I have reached the side with the three stitch markers that indicate where I have to do the buttonholes. The buttonhole is consist of only a series of chains. For the number of the chains that I have to make, the buttonhole size depends on the size of the buttons. In my case, at the end, I chose a bigger button than the ones that I showed you at the beginning. So these are the buttons that I will use. And for this button, I need only three chains. So now for the button hole, chain three. And then two single crochet stitches in this row hand. Okay, now I've made the first buttonhole, so now verify that it's of the right size. So insert the button in the buttonhole in this way. The buttonhole has not to be too wide or too narrow. Okay, it's okay. It's of the right size. So for me, in this case, for a button of 1.5 centimeter in diameter, for this button it's enough a buttonhole of only three chains. So now let's continue with the work. Okay, now in this space I have done two single crochet stitches, chain three, and then two single crochet stitches in next row end. And now two single crochet stitch in next row end. And continue with two single crochet stitches in all the next row hands until to reach the next stitch marker. Okay, now the next row hand is in the next row hand there is the stitch marker, so in this space I have to do the buttonhole, and so now chain three, and then skip the row hand with the stitch marker, and in the next row hand two single crochet stitches. So I made the second buttonhole. Now two single crochet stitches in next row hands until to reach the last stitch marker. Okay, two single crochet. 2 single crochet again. Okay, now have reached the last stitch marker and the last row end. I can remove the second free stitch marker. So now in this space I have to do the buttonhole, so chain 3 and make 2 single crochet stitches in this row hand. 1 single crochet to turn to the upper side and 1 single crochet that corresponds to the single crochet stitch that I should have to make in the first stitch of the last row of the bodies. This is the aspect of the side with the 3 buttonholes. Now I can continue with the finishing edge of all the single crochet stitches on the upper side. So work 1 single crochet stitch in all the stitches of the upper side. So 1 single crochet in all these stitches until to reach the first stitch marker that indicates where I have to do the shoulder strap. So now continue with 1 single crochet stitch in all these stitches. In next stitch there is the first stitch marker and 1 single crochet in this stitch. Okay, now I can do the first shoulder strap. For this sundress I chose an adjustable length shoulder strap made of 2 laces closed together with a bow. 2 laces of only chains and slip stitches, but you can do the shoulder strap differently. You can do them as you prefer. In my case, the 2 laces that form the shoulder strap are made of only chains and slip stitches. How many chains do I have to do? Firstly, the number of chains depends on your dress size. The lace length must to be equal to the armhole depth plus from 15 to 20 cm for the bow, based on how big you want the bow to be. Based on the sundress that I have already done, in this case I will start with about 17 chains. So now I will start with the lace and now chains 17. Okay, I have done 17 chains. Now I don't measure the lace's length because when I will go to do the slip stitches in these chains, the work will tend to shrink. So now I will do the first 10 slip stitches in the first 10 chains and then I will check its length. First of all, now chain 1. Chain 1 to turn the work and to come back. Now in the second chain from the hook, so in this chain, 1 slip stitch. one slip stitch in next chain and continue with one slip stitch in the first 10 chains. Okay, now let's measure. Okay, now it's visible. Okay, I've done 10 slip stitches in the first 10 chains, and now stretch the work. And let's measure it. Okay, 10 chains with 10 slip stitches have a length of 4 cm. Okay, 4 cm. So 10 chains correspond to a length of 4 cm. So 70 chains give a total length of 7 4 4 is equal to 28 cm. So 70 chains are equal to 28 cm. Now, taking into account that the armhole depth for a 18 months old baby is of about 10 cm. So I have 18 cm more for the bow, and it can be fine. So now I can continue with the work. So now one slip stitch in all next chains until to reach the first chain. Now one slip stitch and so on. Okay. One slip stitch and one slip stitch in the last chain. Okay, now I have to control the length of this first lace. Stretch the work. And measure it. Stretch it well. Okay. Okay. It is 27 centimeter long. Yes, 27. Okay, it's right. It can be fine for my sides, so I can continue with the work. 70 chains are enough for the lace, for the two laces of the shoulder strap. So now I can continue with the work, but first of all I have to fix this first lace. I have to fix it with the rest of the bodies. And I will fix it with a slip stitch in the single crochet stitch at the base of the lace in this way. Okay, now one slip stitch in this single crochet stitch, in this one, insert the hook in all the two loops of this stitch in this way. Okay, so, and one slip stitch. Okay, I have done the first lace, the first of the two laces that form the first shoulder strap. Now I can continue with the work and with the finishing edge on the other stitches of the upper side. So one single crochet in all next six stitches until to reach the next stitch marker. When I will arrive in the second stitch marker, I will do the second I will do the second lace that forms the first shoulder strap, and I will do the second lace as the first one. So I will work the same number of chains that I made before for the first lace. So I will made I will do I will do 70 chains. Now in the second stitch marker again one single crochet stitch, and so now chain 70, chain 71, 70 chains for the lace, and one chain to turn the work and come back with one slip stitch in all the chains. So now 17 chains, 71 chains, and 70 slip stitches. Okay, I have done the second lace as the first one, with the 71 chains, one slip stitch in the second chain from the hook, and one slip stitch in all next chains until to reach the first one. Now fix the second lace in the bodies with the one slip stitch in this single crochet stitch in this way. So now I have done also the second lace. So I have finished the first shoulder strap. I can continue with the work and with the finishing edge on the upper side, and so let's continue with one single crochet stitch in all. Okay, firstly check that control that let's control that the two laces are of the same length. So stretch the work, stretch the two laces, and let's control their length. Okay, they are equal. Okay, it's all right, I can continue. So I can continue with the finishing edge and with one single crochet stitch in all the stitches until to reach the next stitch marker where I have to do the first lace of the second shoulder strap in this one. I have to do in this two stitch marker. I have to do the other two laces of the second shoulder strap, and I will do these two laces as done before for the first two laces. So 17, 71 chains and then 70 slip stitches. So now I will continue with the finishing edge until to reach this stitch marker where I will do the first lace, then I will continue with the work until to reach the last stitch marker where I will do the last lace that forms the second shoulder strap. And I will do it as the previous laces, so 71 chains, 17 chains for the lace, one chain to turn the work, and come back with 70 slip stitches. Okay, now let's continue with one single crochet stitch in all the stitches until to reach the next stitch marker. Okay, I have just finished the other two laces of that form the second shoulder strap. And now I will show you how to finish the finishing edge. Now let's continue with the one single crochet stitch in all next stitches until to reach the end of the round and the last space. Okay, one single crochet stitch in next two stitches. And now I am at the end of the round. This is the first row end where there are already two single crochet stitches. In this space I have to work other two single crochet stitches. Don't work in the double crochet stitch but in the space of the row end, two single crochet stitch, and now close the round with a slip stitch in the first stitch. In this one insert the hook in all the two loops of the single crochet and slip stitch. Okay, now it's completed. I have finished the bodies and I can cut the yarn. I leave a long tail of yarn. I will use it to sew the three buttons. But you can use also a sewing thread. You can do as you prefer. In this case, I want to use the same yarn of the bodies. So now I leave a long tail of yarn in this way. Okay, cut the yarn. Okay, now let's see where do you have to show the three buttons? One buttons will be placed to the first row in the first row hand to close the bodice, and another one at the beginning to close the opening in the fabric skirt. And the third button will be placed in the middle between the first two. And so at 5 rows away from the other buttons, so in this row, that is the sixth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's the sixth row from the two buttons. Okay, now I show you how to sew the buttons. Insert the yarn in the needle. Okay, remove the first stitch marker and take the first button. Okay. Okay, move on the back side. I will sew the button on these stitches. The first two single crochet stitches, the first two single crochet stitches of the finishing edge, and the double crochet stitch, the previous double crochet stitch. Be careful to sew the button so that it doesn't exceed these two borders of the bodice. It must be in line with the borders. And I will sew it on these stitches. So now I am in the first stitch. I am in this stitch, and now insert the needle in the second single crochet stitch and in one hole of the button in this way. Okay, insert the needle in the diagonal hole of the button, and on the back insert the needle in the double crochet stitch, in the previous double crochet stitch, and now pull the yarn. Okay, now on the back side, return in the first single crochet stitch of the finishing edge, so in this stitch, okay, now it's visible. Insert the hook, the needle, sorry. In the first single crochet stitch and in the hole on the button. And now insert the needle in the last three hole of the button, and on the back side insert the needle in the double crochet stitch. In the base of the double crochet stitch in this way, and and pull the yarn. Okay, now let's see. Okay, it's in line with the two borders, so it can be fine. Okay, and now pass with the needle in the work to block the work in this way. Make this to block and secure the work. Okay, I have just sewn the first button. Okay, now on the back side, insert the needle in the work and move to the next stitch marker. Move to the position where I have to sew the second button. Another stitch. Okay, I have reached the two single crochet stitches in the row hand indicated by the stitch marker. Now this is the first. Pass with the needle in the back side of the first single crochet stitch of this row hand, and now let's sew the second button as done for the previous one. So insert the needle in the second single crochet stitch and in one hole of the button, and then in the diagonal hole insert the needle and insert it on the back side in the previous double crochet stitch. Okay, in this way. Pull the yarn. Pull it very well, and now return in the first single crochet stitch of this row hand, so in the previous single crochet stitch. Insert the needle in this stitch and in a hole of the button and pull very well the yarn, and insert the needle in the last hole, free hole, and at the base of the double crochet stitch in this way. Okay, and pull the yarn. Okay, I have sewn also the second button. Now, as done before, insert the needle in the work and block the work in this way. And now move to the last stitch marker. Okay, also the second button is in line with the border. And now insert the needle in the work and move to the first stitch marker. The last stitch marker is in the last row hand, where I have to sew the button that close the opening in the fabric skirt. And I have to arrive in that stitch. I will sew the button. Okay, remove the stitch marker, and I will sew the button the first two single crochet stitches. So now insert the hook in the second single crochet stitch, and insert the needle, sorry, in the first single crochet stitch, and in the first hole of the button, and then insert the needle in the diagonal hole and in the double crochet stitch. Pull the yarn and then insert the needle in the first single crochet stitch of this row hand and in the hole of the button, and then insert the hook. Okay, then insert the hook in the last three hole and in the base of the double crochet stitch. And pull very well the yarn. And now, as done before, insert the needle in the work to block the work and block the yarn in the same time. Okay. Now hide the yarn in the work, in the back side of the work, in this way. Do a knot. And hide the hole in the work. Okay, this is the initial thread, and at the time I have only to cut, but now let's continue. Hiding this yarn in the work in this way. And so I am blocking the yarn in the work. Okay. And now, cut the yarn. So now it's finished. The bodice is completed. I have sewn all the three buttons on the bodice. And now I can close it. Okay, now the crochet bodice is completed, and in the next video tutorial, I will show how to do the fabric skirt for the sundress.